friends, very good morning to all of you and welcome to our e-learning class. Students, today I am going to start the first chapter of the topic our hardware components of the computer system and some of the storage devices and software. The student, today is my third video lecture of class 6. Now come to the point. First of all, we will discuss what do you mean by storage device. So student, storage device. Students, before storage device, we have already discussed what do you mean by input device, what do you mean by processing device, and what do you mean by output device. Today we will discuss the storage device. The storage device is used to store the data information for permanently. Is that clear? That means the storage device is also called as a memory. Storage device is also called as a memory of a computer system. That means where the information or data will be stored for the permanently, that is called as a memory. That means the other name of the storage device is memory. So it is also called as a memory. It is also called as a memory. And what are the examples of the memory of storage devices? There are different types of the examples of the storage device for which the data will be stored permanently. For example, flash drive. Examples, flash drive, then CD, then DVD. So these are all the examples of the storage device or memory. Flash drive is also called as a pendrive. Flash drive is also called as a pendrive. CD is also known as a compact disc. DVD known as the digital versatile disc, where the data will be stored permanently. Hard disk also. So many examples of the storage device. Now we have completed the storage device. Now come to the start. What do you mean by software? What do you mean by software? The student, now complete our hardware parts of the computer system. Now come to the software. The software is a set of programs. Software is the set of programs that working of the computer system. The software is the collection of programs that helps to work of the computer system smoothly. Is that clear? That means what we mean by program? It is a collection of programs. Software is a collection of programs. Software is a collection of programs. Now student, what do you mean by program? The program is the set of instructions. Program is the set of instructions. Is that clear? Come to again, software is a collection of program that performs a particular work of a computer system. Then what do you mean by program? Program is a set of instructions that can do a particular task by the computer system. That is a program. Is that clear? So many instructions, that means so many programs are used for developing a software. For example, C, C++, Java, .NET, etc. These are all the programs that helps to make a program and develop the software. Now come to the student. What do you mean by software? We have discussed. Now come to the types of software. Now come to the types of the software. Software is divided into two types: application software and system software. Application, what do you mean by application software, and what do you mean by system software? The application software, it is also a set of programs that performs a particular task, a particular work of a computer system. Means to do a particular work in a computer system, we need application software. For example, suppose I want to make the salary of the employee in an organization. How to make the salary statement of a particular organization? By the help of the payroll software. By the help of the payroll software. That software is used to only the make the salary statement of a particular organization. Next one, some of the students wants to make a drawing in a paint software. That means that paint software is used only to make a drawing. That is a particular work. MS Word is used to make a particular document. Microsoft PowerPoint, that is also used to make a particular document. So these are all the examples of the application software. You remember MS Word, MS Word means PowerPoint, Payroll, Microsoft Paint, WordPad. So these are all the examples of the application software. Now come to the what do you mean by system software? The system software is also a collection of programs that manages or controls the working of a computer system. Once again, I'm repeating you. System software is also a collection of program, is also a collection of programs, is also a collection of programs that manage the that manages the working of computer like this. Is that clear? So that's why we are using the system software. And what are the examples of the system software? Operating system, disk drive, then or device driver, utility software. So these are all the examples of the system software. Operating system, device driver, utility software. Operating system, again, examples, Windows, Linux. So these are all the examples of the operating system. Device driver, printer, sound card. So these are all the examples of the device driver. Next come to the utility software. Device driver, utility software. So these are all the examples of the system software. So students, in this way, we are using the software. So once again, I am repeating you. Software is a collection of programs that is used to perform a particular task in the computer system. The software is divided into two types, application software and system software. The application software is particularly used to perform a particular task and it is used to manage or control the hardware components of the computer system or working of the computer system. So these are all the examples of the application software and these are all the examples of the system software. Student, now if you have any doubt, you can ask.